Hey guys, Scripps County here. How you doing? Love you. Guys, today we're going to talk about Raul again from EGW Capital. I hope I'm pronouncing his name right. I'm not very good for pronouncing names, but Raul has been taking a jab at Ethereum now. This guy's been building on Ethereum, okay, Ethereum assets, and he's also building and using DigiByte assets. So he's comparing the two in these tweets, and I just thought it was kind of interesting, and a lot of people know already what the debacle is already about. So here we go. How can Ethereum expect to be adopted on a mass scale if your gas price costs us moon and time like ages to execute? Vitalik Buterin, we have started experimenting with DigiByte already. Time to wake up or sleep forever. What a profound statement. Like I said, he's been building on Ethereum, and he basically says the gas prices are just moon, way too high for the price to even build upon it. And not only that, he mentions DigiByte here, so pretty cool. In the real world economy, the price of the gas turned negative, but on Ethereum, the gas price is rising. The blockchain was created to DeFi. The government sponsored speculations, but we have started copying those principles to the blockchain. So basically what he's saying here is, how are we going to DeFi government and all these things when everything's already too high? Using this, you're not bettering anything. You just might as well stay in the old world. There's nothing wrong with what he's stating. It needs to be cheaper, period. That's all there is to it. I am deeply saddened to see Ethereum price rising purely on speculation while the people using it is struggling for transactions to go through. Let me remind that crypto is created to serve a purpose. We need technologies like DigiByte to stay and serve Vitalik Buterin. So basically what he's stating here is, look no further, DigiByte is here. And there's a strong case against the naysayers. Basically, he's building the strong case, and a lot of the people are not seeing this at all, the comparisons, which makes me think that the people that have compared DigiByte and Ethereum and have built on both of them absolutely said nothing about the comparison truthfully. It will be compulsory for all EGW Academy students to have a DigiByte wallet address, and we will implement it soon. DigiByte seems to be refined and a better version of Ethereum. Let's see what Ethereum 2 will do. Well, that's pretty self-explanatory. He's basically giving every student a DigiByte address. It's like mandatory almost. And basically he's wanting to see what Ethereum 2 will do. So, he's basically saying, well, let's see what Ethereum 2 does and how much is it going to cost and how slow it is going to be and is it ready for mass adoption and whatnot. But he's basically stating, Raul here from EGW Capital, that DigiByte's there and he has no problems with DigiByte apparently. So well, thank you, man. Thank you for the comparisons. What this bank is doing in India is assetizing real estate with DigiByte, and he is confirming that it's so much easier to build and assetize with DigiByte than it is with Ethereum, hands down, he says. And so basically I believe that they're going to be going with DigiByte. Now he did state in an article before when I first saw this that he has to use the Ethereum blockchain to get it listed on exchanges, on a certain exchange in India, because they use Ethereum for that, and there's no pair for the DigiByte up there for their use. So, but I can guarantee you that this guy's going to fight for that. And but basically he sees liberty in DigiByte, and he sees a future in DigiByte in his country. Really awesome to see. Now, guys, this is my friend Mike. Now, if you guys haven't followed him on Twitter, please do. He's been at the forefront of testing DigiID. He's He's been at the forefront of testing DigiCafe, and he's really grilled in each of those technologies. And really, he's probably really one of the ones I know that has really shown us how it all works, how it's all put together, and how we can improve it with the devs. So yeah, I mean, Mike's doing just a fantastic job for the past year and a half since I've known him. And he's also one of the very ones that builds on DigiAssets and creates DigiAssets like a machine, like a monster, man. There's nothing like it. But he obviously works in Hollywood. And he assetizes things to show us how easy it is to build on DigiAssets. And it is really cool. And I'm just going to let you see this clip and we'll talk a little bit more about it. But this is his asset. Check it out. The Predator asset. This looks awesome. I watched that show as a kid over and over. Never got tired of it. He said he bought an iPhone so he can test trial DigiAssets on iOS. Smart move. Appears he's giving us a video introduction, going back and forth from minimizing, flipping his phone. That works. All right, well, there's the asset ID. Here's all the links he composited in there. Check it all out. That's pretty cool. He can just add the links. You don't even have to waste the space on this asset here. That's pretty cool. It's just something you can do. You can do many things on here. This is one of them. The description. That's really cool, guys. The Predator asset. Well, that's all I got. Script's got it out.